seemed to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faith will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Rather,
remembrance can be that tender place where we discover God's love with us, surrounding us. C.S. Lewis, the great Anglican author, reflects on this in his book entitled A Grief Observed, a book that he wrote after the death of his wife, Helen Joy. In that book, he muses, as we all do, about whether the dead can see us as we continue living here on earth. And he writes honestly in that book about his ache for her actual physical presence. Lewis writes in one part of the book, as if speaking to Joy herself, he says, "We didn't idolize each other. We tried to keep no secrets. You knew the rotten places in me already. If you now see anything worse, I can take it. So can you. Rebuke, explain, mock, forgive, for this is one of the miracles of love. It gives power of seeing through its own enchantments and yet not being disenchanted. To see, in some measure, like God. His love and his knowledge are not distinct from one another, nor from him. We could almost say God sees because he loves, and therefore loves, although he sees." Lewis's words have been sticking with me this week. However we choose to commune with dear ones who have died, this invitation to recognize how love has changed us can strengthen us for continuing on this path of life as we embrace the whole truth and the fullness of our connection with those we have loved who have gone home to eternal rest. Our hope in the promise of that future reunion was a hope we heard bearing witness in the text from 1 Thessalonians today, that provocative image of us all being caught up in the air when Jesus returns to bring the fullness of all time, the recreation of heaven and earth, and the reunion of us with those we have loved and lost. Yes, that is one of those promises that we hold on to in our faith, that one day we will again be reunited in the mirror presence of God. We will get to embrace those dearly departed when all is redeemed in the light of love. Acknowledging these contours of sorrow and joy that shape our memories and color our remembrance of these tender bonds that hold us close in life can help us rediscover that even now we are held in loving remembrance by our Creator, whose grace unites the living with the dead in ways we cannot fathom. Like many, I don't often remember my dreams, but this week I did recall a dream I had about my grandmother. She passed away more than a decade ago. It was early morning this week. I woke up in tears mid-sentence. She had fallen. I was crying out to her, and I knew it was in those precious moments, just as she was about to die. This unsolicited remembrance revealed an unexpected invitation in my life to turn toward that love that connects us even beyond the grave. It doesn't remove any of that honest frustration I used to feel about our patterns of relating to one another, or the sadness that still touches my memories of her as I think about her life and her sorrows and her joys. Maybe the dream shouldn't have surprised me. I had watched that film Coco earlier in the week. Some of you have seen it, I can tell. It's an animated film from Pixar that I commend if you haven't yet had a chance to view it. The story of a little boy, Miguel, who undertakes a journey of discovering, clarifying family connections in his family tree. It's this glorious descent among the dead that's imaginative and vivid and provocative and powerful. Miguel ends up awakening to his own unknown regard for these family traditions of remembrance, honoring those ancestors who had gone before, not just in the way they conducted their daily life as the Rivera family, but in those annual remembrances. gratitude, and love. Remember that God never ceases to hold dear all those whom we have loved, who have died, just as God never forgets us. In the love of God, we are held fast, not only today, but in the fullness of all time and in all place, where all the dear ones whom we carry in our hearts, whether they live on the other side of the country, reside a continent the world over, or already have entered eternal rest. God's love redeems our pain, our suffering, our losses, drawing us together and reconnecting us through love, week by week. Jesus remembers us, bringing us back together here at this Eucharistic table so that we can all see our cherished place in the family picture at the sacred table of remembrance that indeed is God's own. Here, we commune in a sacred meal with the Lord of love who serves as our generous host and our pan de cielo, our bread of heaven, as we say in the Spanish language. Jesus' love bears all to remember us, saving us from the power of sin and death, transforming our experiences through his life willingly laid down, and reconciling us through the grace that transforms and heals everything that we know in this life and in the next. Today, as we honor dear ones whom we love and see no longer, let us also draw comfort in redemption's secret revealed through Christ's own precious offering, a meal of sacrificial love that remembers every one of us within God's wider family, now and for all time. Amen.
Thank you. desire that none should be lost. Gather into your grateful arms those who do not believe, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that they may know your peace, your comfort, and life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Mighty Savior, you bring joy out of grief and life out of death. Look with mercy upon all who mourn. Carry those who struggle or suffer through times of darkness and strengthen them with the embrace of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of transformation, you are tender towards your children and your mercy surrounds creation. Heal memories of hurt and failure. Give us wisdom and courage rightly to use the time we are given here on earth to serve Christ and to follow in his way of love that leads us into life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Prince of Peace, your love reconciles all peoples. We remember veterans and all those from diverse tribes and nations who have laid down lives in sacrificial service to peoples and countries. Transform the hatred and pride that polarizes your family and heal our human pain. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord of kindness, you inspire our care for one another. We thank you for tender-hearted friends in this community, especially all who orchestrate St. Paul's celebration of life gatherings. May their ministry honor our dear departed and reveal your presence with us, comforting us in our sorrows. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us say our prayer for mission together.
Accept the prayers committing ourselves to what God is calling us to do and to be in this place through our pledges and prayers and offerings of love. It will be many things coming in the days to come, but for today, we invite you to receive a rose after we receive communion and to take it home with you, but if you'd like to place it on the table of remembrance for the remainder of the service and then pick it up on your way out, we hold in love and in gratitude all those that we carry on our hearts this day. So let us walk in love. to your feet, delightful people, O Lord. Life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gave it to his disciples and said, thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is dying. Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his life, death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Thank you.
great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever.